Hello friends. In this video, we will examine a lighting control device, a dimmer, which, in addition to turning lights on and off, can also adjust brightness. This model is designed for installation in an electrical panel on a standard DIN rail and has the dimensions of a standard circuit breaker. It can be used with lighting fixtures that support brightness adjustment and operate on the power grid. These could include energy saving, LED, and incandescent bulbs, as well as dimmable LED controllers. Control can be managed either through a smart home system. We'll check the controller's compatibility with some of these systems in this video, or via an external doorbell switch. Additionally, the device can operate in Zigbee groups. Before we start, as usual, I ask you to like this video so that more people interested in smart home technology can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Device type, dimmer for DIN rail installation. Model, GLEDOPTO GL-SD-003P. Interfaces, Zigbee 3.0, RF 2.4 GHz. Operating voltage range, 100 to 240 volts. Maximum load current, 1.5 amps. Operating temperature, minus 20 to 60 degrees Celsius. Dimensions, 24 by 59 by 91 millimeters. The device comes in a small box designed in the manufacturer's standard style, black and red. On one side, the technical specifications I just listed are indicated. The package is very minimalistic. Besides the controller itself, there's only an instruction manual. But then again, nothing more is really needed. The manual is in English and includes the device's specifications and instructions on how to connect and synchronize it, both with the control app and with external controllers. A wiring diagram is provided. As I mentioned, the featured device is in the form factor of a circuit breaker, although it's a bit wider, 24 millimeters instead of the standard 18 millimeters. This means three dimmers will take up the same space on the rail as four circuit breakers. At the top, there are four screw terminals, incoming phase and neutral, as well as two terminals for connecting an external doorbell switch. At the bottom, there are also four terminals, paired together, two for outgoing phase and two for outgoing neutral, which are used to connect the load. On the housing, there are two buttons, reset, for resetting and entering pairing mode, and level, for manual control. It functions similarly to an external switch, short press to turn on or off, and hold for dimming. Mounting on the DIN rail is done with a plastic clamp. First, it needs to be pulled out, then the dimmer is placed on the rail, and after that, it's pushed back in to secure. On the sides of the device, you can see clips that hold the two halves of the casing together. Disassembly is very simple and does not damage the casing, so let's take a look inside. Using a flat object, press on the side clips and gently remove the front part of the casing. The components are mounted densely, designed to fit the specific shape of the casing. The device includes two radio interfaces, Zigbee and RF, both operating at a frequency of 2.4 GHz, so there are two identical antennas. Everything looks high quality and neatly assembled. On the back, there are additional soldered power traces. Judging by the markings on the boards, the device was manufactured no earlier than the first half of 2023. Moving on to testing, I set up a small test stand where the dimmer is connected to a power line and a socket is connected to its output. The load will be a dimmable filament LED bulb. Turning on and off is done with a short press on the level button. The external switch works in the same way. Holding down the button adjusts the brightness, alternating between increasing and decreasing. At minimum brightness, the light turns off. To enable pairing mode, press the reset button 5 times quickly. The light connected to the dimmer will enter a breathing mode. starting with the Tuya Smart app for testing smart home compatibility. For Zigbee devices, a gateway is required. I'll be using a wired version that supports HomeKit. The device is identified and connected as a controllable light bulb. In terms of functionality, the dimmer behaves like a dimmable bulb in the system. The app interface is simple. There's an on/off switch and brightness control. The settings menu is in the top right corner. It's also possible to create a schedule for automatically turning the light on and off, either once or periodically, specifying the days of the week. In the settings menu, you can specify the type of bulb in use, LED, incandescent, or energy saving. Below this, there's a slider to set the minimum brightness level. Once set, brightness cannot be lowered below this level in the app. However, in third-party apps like Google Home, which we'll discuss shortly, brightness control still works on the full scale. In the general settings menu, you'll find standard options like compatibility with third-party systems, group integration, firmware version check, it came with the latest version, sharing access, and device removal. However, I didn't find any option in the plugin to set the behavior after power restoration. Now let's look at how the dimmer can be used in automations. It can act as a trigger, an event that initiates an action by using the status and state of the light. Status refers to whether it's on or off, while state checks if brightness is greater than, less than, or equal to a specified level. For example, an automation can be triggered if brightness falls below 25%. These same parameters can also be used as actions in the then section of automations. You can turn the light on or off, but there's a noticeable lack of an option to toggle it. You can also set the desired brightness. As an example, if brightness is below 25%, it can be set to 100% and then the light will turn off. This way, when turned on next, it will remember its state and come on at full brightness. Checking the claimed compatibility with Google Home. To do this, go to the menu for compatible devices and add your Tuya Smart account. This is a one-time step, after which all supported devices in Google Home will appear here automatically. Standard options are available here, turning the light on or off and adjusting brightness. Even if a brightness limit is set in the Tuya app, the full scale works here. As I mentioned earlier, the gateway I'm using for this test supports HomeKit and is connected through the Home Assistant integration. This allows us to check compatibility using this protocol in both systems. Although I've often encountered devices, especially lights, where compatibility existed despite not being officially supported, in this case, it's not available. The dimmer cannot be used in HomeKit, even with a compatible gateway. And while the dimmer is still connected to the gateway, let's check its native integration in Home Assistant, called Tuya. Later, we'll return to Home Assistant using alternative coordinators. The dimmer is added as a regular light bulb, with only one object and no additional settings or parameters. Control is basic, allowing you to turn it on, off, and adjust brightness. This integration requires internet access but works simultaneously with the native Tuya Smart app and Google Home. Now it's time to disconnect the dimmer from the native gateway and test it with other systems, starting with the local smart home control center, Sonoff iHost. Two new updates were released shortly before this test. The current version at the time of filming is 2.3.4, and all further actions will be on this version. The iHost has its own Zigbee coordinator, allowing direct device connections. By the way, after the update, the connection window view has changed, adding the option to connect Matter devices. The device was detected and recognized correctly, even displaying an image of it. Here's how the dimmer looks on the connected devices page. Its current status is visible, off at the moment. In its tab, there's a state switch, brightness control, scheduling, delay, and a cyclic timer. The settings and general information menu has an option I didn't find in the native app, behavior after power restoration. When power is restored, the light can always turn on, stay off, or remember its last state. I checked, and all settings work correctly. For example, If the light was on when power was lost, it will turn on again. If it was off, it will remain off. Automation options are also available here and, importantly, work locally without internet. In the If Triggers section, only the on and off events are available. This is the Actions section. What will be executed if the automation trigger is activated? Here, you can control both the state and brightness of the light connected to the dimmer. An option that wasn't in the native app was also found here, state reversal. This means the same trigger will alternately turn the light on and off. It's logical and convenient. As promised, we're back in Home Assistant, but now using alternative coordinators. In this case, a USB stick with SkyConnect firmware. Link to the review is in the description, and the native integration for working with Zigbee devices, ZHA. After removing the dimmer, it automatically enters pairing mode. This is convenient. I removed it from iHost, and it was immediately picked up by ZHA. In addition to the light object, there's a firmware version sensor, a setting for power recovery state, and an identification button. Like most other Zigbee devices with permanent power and a neutral line, the dimmer acts as a router in the network, meaning it can relay data to and from other network nodes. You can turn the device on and off and control brightness. Unlike the Tuya integration we discussed earlier, there's no dependency on the internet here. The power recovery behavior options include an additional setting compared to iHost, toggle. In this case, when power is restored, the light will assume the opposite status from what it had before the outage. I tested all the options on the stand, and they all work correctly. Full functionality is available in ZHA. The last system to test is Zigbee 2 MQTT. The current version at the time of testing is 1.41.0. Here, the dimmer was correctly identified, and there was no need for external converters. Manufacturer, model number, and image are all correct. A quick reminder, the device acts as a router in the Zigbee network. The exposures page includes a state switch, brightness slider, effects menu, four power recovery behavior options, and signal quality level. One new feature we see here is the effects. Visually, they all look the same. The light dims and turns back on. I didn't notice any difference among them. In other respects, it's similar to ZHA. Since a wireless Zigbee dimmer from a previous review is still connected here, we can check if this dimmer supports group operation. Just to recap, when using this control method, the wireless dimmer manages lights in the group directly, even without a coordinator. From the list of devices, select the desired one, in this case, the dimmer. Functionally, it behaves like a light. Add it to the group. Its current state and brightness level are visible. Pressing the wireless dimmer turns it on and off, while rotating the knob adjusts the brightness. The dimmer does support group operation. Feedback works well. When changing light settings, the updates appear almost immediately on the control panel. Brightness adjustment with this dimmer is very smooth, maybe even a bit too much. One other thing I noticed is that for smooth operation, you need a brief delay between turning the dimmer knob. But overall, everything works, and this method can be used as a fail-safe control method, which is more convenient than an external mechanical switch. The device reviewed here impressed me as a lighting control option with dimming functionality. It works well. However, keep in mind that the fixture itself must support this feature. There is only one control channel, so it can't adjust color temperature, only brightness. Power capacity is sufficient, up to 400 watts for incandescent bulbs and up to 200 watts for energy saving or LED bulbs. It's fairly compatible with various control systems, although it lacks HomeKit support, which is somewhat surprising since the control is completely standard. That's all for now. I hope you found this video useful and interesting. I'd appreciate your likes, as they help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, please subscribe to my channel. In the description, you'll find all necessary links. To to stores where you can order this dimmer, to other lessons and reviews on this topic, my Telegram channels, Facebook page, and a discussion group on smart home topics. Join us. It'll be interesting. Thank you for watching. See you next time, and peace to all.